Peace, this is Jarrell with Climb Like Consciousness. Today I want to talk about energy manipulation and moving large amounts of energy. Okay, this is something that isn't really talked about. This is something that I am very interested in and is very important for people to learn out there. If you're awakening, ascending, evolving, and developing as a person on your spiritual path. Primarily because you have to spin your energy. You have to understand your energy. You have to understand the forces that are working against you as you continue to awaken and progress and move into more of who you are. All right, these are the things that are not taught to you, of course. I say that in every video. However, it's true. Nobody's going to teach you this stuff. Nobody is going to tell you to get in a field of energy and spin a vortex of light around you. Okay, it's very important to just understand that you are a pillar of light. You're a vortex of light in a sphere, in a toroidal sphere. And when you spin that toroidal sphere, you're making yourself a lot stronger and a lot more powerful than you can really possibly imagine. Like, when you spin your energy, you begin to move clouds. Okay, when I sit out here and do these videos, sometimes I sit out here, here comes the wind. When I sit out here and do these videos, sometimes I sit out here 15, 20 minutes before just so I can clear the sky and so I can actually dissolve the pollution clouds that every person in this town thinks are normal clouds, and they're not. They're just smoke floating in the air. It's just smoke floating in the air from the pollution that they dump out from the planes at 30,000 feet, okay? So when you get into your energy and actually start moving your own energy with your own heartbeat and the resonant energy of the planet Earth, you begin to actually do wonders, okay? If you're in a bad mood, you begin to actually be able to shift your mood. If you have dissonant energy on you, you begin to actually move that energy off of you. That's very important. If you have a bad dream and you wake up in a bad mood, that bad energy that caused that bad dream came from somewhere outside of you. You can actually get up in the morning and spin energy off of you, all right? As part of your morning routine. A lot of people do meditation, a lot of people do yoga, a lot of people do breath work, you know, as part of their morning routine. If you spin energy, what you do is that you actually wrap yourself in energy. You actually spin and become energy. You become a vortex and you begin to actually manipulate the ether around you. That's what martial arts is, okay? So that's what I want to talk about. There's many different ways to do this. When you ground yourself to the planet Earth, you're grounding yourself to your current timeline. If there's a fifth dimensional Earth under your feet, you're grounding yourself to your fifth dimensional timeline. And when you spin energy around yourself, what you're doing is you're expanding your potential to stay on that timeline. So you're basically ensuring the success and the inevitability that heaven on Earth or fifth dimensional Earth will actually become present on the planet Earth by you just existing, okay? Now, spinning energy is very easy, all right? I used to talk about it in past videos. Basically, what you do is you stand in a pillar of light and you bring golden rings of light down around your feet, pass down around your feet, down to the planet Earth, and you basically bring more of them and spin them around you, you know, in a counterclockwise fashion. So if you were to look down, you'd spin the rings that they're going clockwise. And if you look up, you'd spin the rings that they're going counterclockwise. Okay? So when you do this, you can actually move clouds. You can move the air. You can shift negative entities, negative frequencies, negative weaponized devices and implants and sicknesses and diseased energies out of your field, okay? So it's very important to understand that you have power. You have a lot of power to work with. Your vessel isn't just like a little 3D thing that you use to walk around, eat, and, you know, watch TV and use a computer with and scroll on your phone with. It's a lot more than that. It's very highly developed and sophisticated to actually do many different things as a super existential container for a God being. Okay, that's why they call it a vessel. It's an empty container that houses a God being, a illuminated being of light. Okay, so when you spin energy, you're becoming a vortex to bring your higher timeline into your reality. When I do it, I like to do a martial art when I'm doing it. Okay, when you use anything like a sword or nunchucks or a staff, what you're doing is you're turning into a vortex, right? And that vortex is actually moving through you, okay? So if anybody does martial arts out there, you know how grounded and in the zone you can get when you're spinning a weapon, okay? Because you're actually activating that etheric, eternal version of yourself, whether you know it or not. Alright, that's why it's important to understand how to spin, what direction to spin, and how to ground yourself. Alright, so when you ground yourself, basically just be in a pillar of light and spin rings around you. Okay, because when I spin energy, I'm actually wrapping myself in energy. I'm wrapping the frequency around me, say, hey, you know, I don't want this negativity from these people who are walking around unconscious in a SimCity program. I don't want that. They can have or do whatever they please with that. That's not for me. I'm going to include a video at the end of this. Basically, it's going to show you how I do it. I want to show you, I'll show you my pattern, my energy pattern.
Thank you.